YDNA can be a very powerful addition to your family history research, but is it right for you? Let's find out together in this 5 minutes with your DNA guide, Diahan Southard. It's important to remember that there are three different kinds of DNA tests you can take for your family history, and YDNA is used to trace only your direct male line, so your father's 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 line. So if you would, take just a minute and think to yourself, who is this ancestor? Who is your father's father's father that perhaps you would like to learn more about? That's what this YDNA test is all about. It's about finding out more about him. So this works because YDNA is passed down basically unchanged from generation to generation. So a man will pass his YDNA on to his sons, and his son will pass it on to the next generation, and so on and so on and so on, which brings up a really good point. Only men can take a YDNA test. So ladies, that doesn't mean that we are exempt, right? It just means we have to get the right person to take the test for us. And we want to do this because YDNA can help us distinguish between different lines that have the same surname. It can also help us link different surnames together, and sometimes it can even help us sort out family relationships. So in order to get a YDNA test, you would be tempted to go to one of these three DNA testing companies. They're all offering YDNA testing. Now, if we were together in my YDNA workshop, then we would be doing some hands-on classwork while I'm teaching you. So it's a really fun and interactive way to learn. And I guess I better move myself out of the way. I'll put myself up here. There we go. So I'd provide you this chart in the workbook, and then we would fill out this chart together to help you decide which testing company might be right for you. So without the benefit of all that information, I'm going to go out on a limb and say that probably most of you will want to test with Family Tree DNA. They offer the most comprehensive kind of YDNA testing. So let's say you do. Let's say you test with Family Tree DNA. And when you log in, you're going to come to your dashboard, and your dashboard's going to contain some information about your YDNA test. So at the top of your YDNA dashboard section, you're going to see this little bar that tells you how many YDNA markers you've had tested. So marker's just a location you can test on the YDNA. So right up there, you can see, oh, I've tested at 37 markers. If I wanted to, I could upgrade, which just means pay more money, and they could test more markers for me. Also on the dashboard, you're going to see a group projects section. Here you'll see any group projects that you're a part of. And hands down, this is the best next step for anyone. Join a group project. They're very powerful, and their administrators are usually very helpful. So you can absolutely do that. Just join a project. Join the project that corresponds to your surname. You'll also see on the dashboard this little badge that tells you about your haplogroup, which is just a deep ancestral group, and you can learn more about your haplogroup within the Family Tree DNA platform as well as in other places on the web. But mostly, you want to look at the YDNA Matches section. When you click on YDNA Matches, it's going to default to show you this detailed view. For me, the detailed view is a little overwhelming, so I always switch to the table view. So in the table view, they're going to present you with the information that they think you need to help you figure out how you might be related to individuals on your match list. So let's start by looking at this column that tells you how many markers an individual's had tested. Remember, we were just talking about markers, how you can test 37, 67, 111. So in this column, it tells you about the markers that other people have had tested. In general, if other people on your match list have had more markers tested, it would probably benefit you to have those markers tested as well. It just gives you the best comparison between other people who've taken a test. But the most important column to look at in this whole entire table, if I can get there we go, is the genetic distance column. So the genetic distance column tells you how closely related you are to this particular YDNA match. In general, you want this number to be 3 or fewer. So it says steps, you want this to be 3 steps or fewer in order for you to have a recent connection to this particular match. Now, my 3-step rule, you can break it on occasion, but you should stick to it if you've tested at 67 or 37 markers. If you've tested at 111, I'll let you have 5 differences from your profile, but that's pretty much where I draw the line. Now, you'll see over here there's this actions section, and I love that they've called it actions because they want you to take action. So all of these individuals that have the filled in little pedigree icon have posted their family tree. This is amazing. Look at how many people on my match list have posted a family tree. This makes it really easy to investigate the ancestry of someone else so you can determine how you're related to them. Next up, we have a notes section where you can write down about your correspondence or any other ideas you have about your relationship. And then you have a little, like, I don't even know. It used to be called the tip calculator if you're familiar with the old family tree DNA. Now it's this little icon that tells you, hey, do you want to learn a little bit more about your relationship? Essentially, what this table tells you is when you should start looking for your common ancestor. So I recommend looking for your common ancestor at the 70 to 85% mark. So in this particular relationship, you can see that these two people, it's 70% likely they'll be related at or before six generations, and 85% likely they'll be related at or before eight generations. So this tiny little tool is really powerful in helping you determine when you should be looking for your common ancestor. One other thing I wanted to show you is this filter button. This filter button, it's a great idea. Most of the time you don't need it, but sometimes you'll want to see people who are part of your group project, and this is the way that you find just those individuals. I also want to mention that if you click on any individual's name, it will bring up their little profile page, so you can reach out and contact them directly by using their email address, which is pretty amazing, actually. So that's it for our family tree DNA YDNA test results. Let me scoot myself over here. Here's your action items, your next steps. I think you should focus on that genetic distance column. Make sure you're only trying to evaluate matches who have three or fewer differences from your profile. Use the tip calculator, that little icon I just showed you, to determine when you might find your common ancestor with someone. And you may want to upgrade if you have matches who've tested at a higher level than you have. It will just give you a better idea of when you share a common ancestor. So until next time, I'm Diahan Southard, your DNA guide.